Welcome, class of 2021. It is so great to see our seniors together. It makes my heart warm. So I'm happy that you have joined us here today to celebrate in our Decision Day 2021. Before we begin the ceremony, I have some special welcomes and thank yous to announce. To the class of 2021, since last March, you have found yourself in uncharted territory. We were all put in a position, practically overnight, to adjust to a new reality, and it has been quite the journey since. I stand here today and tell you how proud I am of each and every one of you for the persistence, patience, hard work, and never give up attitude. The staff of Monroe Public Schools and the community of Monroe salute you for what you have overcome to be here today. Next, I would like to welcome the TFT and MHS staff. I cannot thank you enough for being able to pivot as well from obstacles we have faced since last March. For your unwavering dedication to the students of our school has been incredible. I am proud to be your colleague in the effort to educate our students. Thank you for the guidance, support, and care you have shown our students, specifically our seniors today, during their journey to their post-secondary plans. Thank you, staff. I'd like to welcome and thank you parents and family members of our Monroe Trojans. Thank you for the support you have shown your student and our school community. We know it has been challenging for everyone during this last year, and we cannot say enough how much we value your support. Thank you, families. Dr. Everly. Oh, sorry, the wind is blowing my hair. I apologize for that. Dr. Everly, Superintendent of Monroe Public Schools, thank you for your leadership and unwavering support of our students, teachers, parents, and community members. Thank you, Dr. Everly. I would like to thank our school board members for believing in and supporting our students and staff. Thank you, board members. Finally, I would like to give a special welcome to those joining from remote sites. Seniors, I know we have many people from all over watching this live stream, including the elementary and middle schools that you may have attended. I'm about to announce the schools who are joining us, so when I announce your school, give them a shout out or a quick clap. Joining us from Arborwood Elementary, welcome Arborwood Elementary. Welcome Custer Elementary. Welcome Manor Elementary. Welcome Raisinville. Welcome Waterloo. All right. And welcome Monroe Middle School. That's everybody, right? We welcome all of you, and we are so glad you can join us to celebrate this Decision Day 2021. I would like to recognize our senior foreign exchange students. When I call your name, just give a wave or feel free to stand. Maria Roseo Gili from Spain. And Sarah Storti from Italy. Both students are in Mr. Steele's TFT. I know this has been a very unique experience for you, and I thank you for being a part of our Monroe Trojan family. Thank you. Now, I'd like to explain the purpose of our ceremony today. The purpose of Career and College Decision Day is to acknowledge and celebrate the progression you have made from elementary school and middle school to where you are today. Although you will each declare a decision, this is not the end of the journey. In fact, it's just the beginning. Your teachers, kindergarten through 12th grade, and all MPS staff have worked hard to make an impact on you. They wanted you to learn that hard work pays off, that setting goals gives you direction, and problem solving will be your ticket to no matter what life throws at you. At this time, I'd like to introduce Superintendent Dr. Everly to say a few words. Dr. Everly.
I need the microphone just a little bit lower than you, Mr. Polizzi. Good afternoon, class of 2021. And good afternoon to our students and families and friends and the staff of Monroe Public Schools. Decision Day is one of my favorite days because it marks the very beginning of the graduation season. It signifies a learning community coming together to focus on the accomplishments and the achievements of you, class of 2021. I'd like to take a moment and encourage you to do the same and think about all the different celebrations, all the parties that you've had with your classes through your time in school, through your whole school, all of your school years. Because those celebrations are important. Because when you think about what we celebrate, it really reveals what we care about, what we value. And in Monroe, this day focuses on results. You are here. You are about ready to reveal your post-secondary plan to the world. You're going to showcase your plan, and the world will see it, from families joining us around the world to our youngest students who are sitting in Young Fives classrooms right now. They are the class of 2034. So we're here today to join you in your investment. Whether you've been with Monroe Public Schools for a short time or your entire educational career, it has been a pleasure. We've watched you grow up. We've watched you make many, many decisions along the way. And now you're ready to share one of the biggest with us. As I've watched you grow, it's been a real delight. Whether you were at a field day in elementary school, singing the tutti-ta, or doing that thing where you rush below the swing when you're not really supposed to be rushing below the swing when it's up there. You've stayed home for days and days during the polar vortex earlier in your high school career. You've enjoyed many triumphant wins, especially those at Bedford. And you have now experienced a very unique moment with the rest of the world in the last 15 months. It has been hard work, very hard work. And you've watched the world have challenges and you've experienced those. I can only help but wonder how it will sound at your 10-year, 20-year, or 30-year reunion when you say, remember our senior year? You have unique skills. In fact, one of the groups of seniors I was talking with a few weeks ago, they were saying, we've learned things this year that we probably never would have learned. And I don't understand, and this was very interesting to me, I don't understand how it can feel like we're such a close community when we've been distance and lengths, and even when we're in person, 6 feet apart, but yet we're closer. I think there's great insight in that, and I learned a lot from those seniors. Another group of seniors I was visiting with in Mr. Rausch's AP Calc class said, you know, I really would like to talk to you more. This was mid-year. I'd really like to talk to you more about how we can help everyone be successful this school year. And we had a great conversation about that, and many of the ideas they've shared helped others. This is what I think of when I think about you as a class. You have such unique grit and such unique passion and such admirable Trojan strength. And right now, more than ever, this world needs leaders who understand the meaning and the value of coming together and working together, struggling together, and achieving together. And all of you are examples of that. So, with that, your roots are strong. This will always be your home, and you can always know that we will have your back. And so, on behalf of each and every staff member and our Board of Education, I want you to know that we believe in you, and we are behind you every step of the way. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Everly, for those beautiful words. At this time, we have a special video to play for you, presented by your fellow senior classmates. But before we play the video, there are some special thank yous to MHS staff that made this event possible. I would like to thank Mrs. Walkers, post-secondary planner, and now Monroe Middle School counselor, counselors Mr. Hookrattle, Ms. Warnke, Mr. Hoffman, SSPs, Mrs. Ivy, Mrs. Stoner, and Mrs. Clark, Freshman Academy Administrative Assistant, Mrs. Medina, and event planner. She's amazing at event planning. She did a wonderful job. Mrs. Carr, Mrs. Massagill, and Mrs. Devenish also. And I want to also thank the Monroe High School Parent Advisory Team, led by Mrs. Mignano, for providing our scholarships and poster winner gift cards. I'd like to thank Red Letter and Kevin Hauser for this great setup and the tech support. And finally, I'd like to thank my administrative team, Mrs. Ferkus, Mrs. Morelli, Mr. Foley, and Dr. Ray. Thank you all for making this event possible for our seniors. Finally, I have a special thank you to the Student Decision Day Advisory Group. This team included Parker Stamper, Mallory Everly, Selena Milligan, Erica Wood, Morgan Burkett, Rainey Owens, Justin Rothman, and Mitchell Meyer. Your input and feedback were very helpful in designing this day for our seniors. Thank you, seniors. I'd like to welcome to the stage seniors Mallory Everly and Parker Stamper to introduce the video.
Good afternoon, class of 2021. It's hard to believe that this time has finally come.
I'm like my mom, I need to move it down a little bit. Parker and I, along with the other members of the Decision Day Committee, have worked extremely hard on the video that you are all about to view momentarily.
Although our senior year has been a little bit different than we expected, it's important for all of us to take a step back and laugh a little bit.
We hope that each and every one of you enjoys our video just as much as we did. Parts of it may come as a surprise or even may seem a little bit different than what you expected to happen.
You may be prepared for a traditional video, or you may even be expecting to see certain individuals when in all reality it ends up being completely different.
Nevertheless, this video is a good reminder for all of us that different doesn't always mean bad. It's a good reminder that a situation is only as good, bad, boring, or as funny as we make it. With that being said, we hope you enjoy our walk down memory lane starting on March 13th, 2020. Congratulations, seniors, and happy Decision Day.
Hello, everyone. We have unfortunate news for everyone today. We will be taking an extended 2-week spring break as of March 13th due to the COVID scare. We will come back better than ever quickly after, But for right now, we need everyone to go home, stay safe, and stay healthy. Thank you. Hello again, everyone. It is that time of the year where I am to make another announcement regarding the COVID safety and return to school actions. Unfortunately, we will not be able to return to school for the rest of this year. The COVID numbers are still rising and it is not safe for our students. I advise you all in this time to relax, have some de-stress. I suggest doing that by possibly kicking your feet up on the table and just de-stressing. I look forward to seeing you all later in this fall. As for now, have a happy summer and enjoy.
Don't worry about a thing.
Hello everyone and welcome back. I'd like to make this video teaching you all how to properly disinfect yourselves and your surroundings to stay COVID safe. I'm going to be using my disinfectant spray for the course of this video. First off, I'd like you to take a good hand rag. Make sure you're always cleaning it. Make sure you need to clean the hand rag with your good Puro hand sanitizer. You can never get too much of that on there. It's really, you need to keep yourself safe, you know? Okay, here we go. So first off, I'm going to show you, we disinfect all of our papers here. You can see that we have all of our COVID relief and COVID safety papers here. We need to really make sure we wipe down everything and anything. Make sure after you wipe it down, you wash your hands, you hand sanitize and keep yourself safe. Next, we also have all of our masks. Make sure that you're always wearing a mask of any kind that provides safety from people around you and to help others. I myself wear glasses. And a helpful tip to keep the fog off your glasses is to make sure you have a very large tissue at all times in your mask. It can prevent fog. Look, great. Also, I'd like to show you our COVID plans for returning to the fall. As you can see, we have phase one. And then also, I'd like to point out all of our disinfectants that we use every day within the buildings, at all times. This is our Lysol heavy duty spray, and then also we have our X-Effect, which means you don't get to know what's in it. It's a cleaner that we will use all throughout the building. Thank you all for participating in this, and I hope you are all social distancing and masking up. Thank you.
White. Wipe, wipe it down. Wipe, 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 wipe it down. Wipe.
The circus, Afro circus, Afro circus, Afro polka dot, polka dot.
Work, 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 work. You see me heavy work, 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 work. You see me do me that.
Hello everyone. I have amazing news for you all today. Our COVID numbers are finally down and we are ready to take on in-person learning. I have been waiting for this day among the rest of you for months on end, and I am so excited to be able to announce our back to school learning program. More information will be coming soon, but I hope you are all as excited as I am to finally get back in the classroom. And I hope to see you all there. Thank you so much, and we will see you soon. Hello, everyone. I am back with some unfortunate news. We will no longer be able to support and continue the in-person learning program in Monroe Public Schools. The COVID numbers have had a gigantic spike since the beginning of this week, and we have too many students in danger, and we would rather focus on the safety and well-being of our students. I hope you all understand this in a difficult time, and rest assured, when the COVID numbers are at a sustainable level, we will try again with our in-person learning. Thank you all, and I will see you soon. Thank you.
I've seen that video like 5 times and I cry every time I watch it. Mitchell Meyer, you have a future, my man. Wow. The details, like the bracelets, the hair was on point. I mean, wow. That was beautiful, beautiful. Thank you. Thank you for that, seniors. All right. At this time, we would like to begin the tradition of our Monroe Trojans declaring their post-secondary decisions. Here's a quick explanation of what is about to happen. Each student, beginning in 9th grade, is assigned a TFT class and teacher. As many of you know, TFT stands for Trojan Family Time. For 4 years, our TFT teachers play a vital role in getting to know their students in order to serve as a mentor, advocate, and cheerleader. Part of the curriculum for TFT is career and college readiness lessons and activities. We will have the TFT teacher announce each of their students as they begin their walk across the stage to hold up their sign of intent. The students will then sign the commitment banner at the end of the stage. We will now have the first section come down to the track. Mr. Hookrattle. Miss Yania.
I'm gonna have to move it down too. Okay, I won't hold you up too long. I just wanna say a few words about my amazing TFT. And I know that most people get up here and say they have an amazing TFT, but mine really are. Even though I adopted them partway through 9th grade, when their teacher left for a different school, and I was a little worried being they were 9th graders, I hadn't had 9th graders before, they were, and still are, the best TFT I could hope for. They came from different groups in the building, but in my class, they were always one group, one family, never made cliques. They always were friends with each other. They were always kind to each other, always respectful to each other, always caring to each other. Never, ever in 3 or 4 years were there a single problem. Never did I have to say, okay, knock it off, be nice, nothing, ever. I couldn't have been blessed with a better group of kids from anywhere, from any school district, right here at Monroe High School. We know how to treat each other with goodness, tolerance, and understanding. You showed it, no matter what anybody says about Monroe High. We have it here. They've grown a lot in the last 3 or 4 years, emotionally and with knowledge, but they've always kept that kindness in their hearts. Thank you. I love you guys. You will always be my family. And I know no matter where you go, you will do amazing things. So now I'll introduce them and you'll see where they're going. First, we have Evelyn Favreau. She will be attending Monroe County Community College, and then she'll be transferring to major in psychology. Woo-woo! Next, we have Jessica Folkrod, who will be attending Western Michigan University, majoring in dance. Next, we have Brenda Galagos Jimenez, attending Eastern Michigan to pursue a career in nursing. Yay! And then we have Brooklyn Figueroa, who will be on the women's wrestling team in Indiana Institute of Technology, majoring in medical engineering. Yay, Brooklyn. Guys are going so fast. Ella Foshag will be attending Monroe County Community College. She is undecided, but will do great things at a different university after there. Diana Evans will be attending the University of Northwestern Ohio to get an associate's in high performance technology. Hold on a second. Andrew Fryer will be attending Monroe County Community College to pursue a career in education or zoology. Norberto or Berto Flores will be attending Michigan State to study psychology. Zachary Everett will be attending Michigan State, is undecided right now what the major will be, but will be wonderful. Emily Folger will be attending Monroe County Community College, then University of Toledo, to major in elementary education. Right. Hold on, Mel. Mel Marvello Campos will be attending Western Michigan, majoring in aviation flight science. Nathan Morales will be joining the National Guard. Thank you, Nathan. And Mr. Bell's next.
How's it going? Good. Hello, everyone. Can't believe it's been 4 years. I remember when I first got these guys, we were watching our first decision day, coming up with the weird names that I would be announcing. They all said, no way today, so I'll keep it nice and short and sweet. First off, we have Adam Alamo, who will be attending Eastern Michigan University. We have Ariana Alamo. She'll be going to University of Toledo. Alex Ossenmacher, be going to Monroe County Community College, transitioning to Eastern Michigan for a construction management program. Isaac Bagnell, going to Monroe County Community College. Elijah Ball, going to University of Toledo. And Adam Baltrip, going to Grand Valley State University. Congratulations to all seniors.
Hello. How are you? Hi. Hi. I'm Mrs. Blankenship, and this is my senior TFT. It's been quite an interesting 4 years with this group, but I can't be more proud of them. They've all made it this far. So we have Alan Alston, who will be going to Monroe County Community College, majoring in small engine. Kyle Apperson, who is going to join the workforce at first and then going to continue on to some kind of undecided program. Dylan Brooks, he is actually a transfer student to us, and we are super proud of him because he made quite the transition over here. He'll be going to the Transition Center. Jaden Downs. He will be attending Project Search over at ProMedica Hospital in the fall. Sarah Reyna, she will be attending Bloomfield College in New Jersey with a major in art animation. Awesome. Trenton Schultz, he'll also be attending the workforce. And last but not least, Gabriel Van Hoos will be attending MCTI for culinary.
If there's any other kids from our TFT.
Mrs. McBroom scattered class.
Okay, all right, thanks. Yep.
Hey, how are you? Good to see you. Yeah. Congratulations to all you seniors, class of 2021. Thank you for being here. I get to introduce my family. And before I do, I just want to say that I admire you for all your hard work, your dedication, and your persistence. And I wish you all my best. So introducing first will be Emma Chappell. Emma will be attending the University of North Carolina, Wilmington. And she's studying criminology, and she'll be playing Division I volleyball. Next up, we've got Colin Charnock. Colin will be attending Adrian College. He's majoring in entrepreneurship, and he's playing, Colin, soccer, not tennis, soccer. Up next, Lauren Cox. She'll be attending the University of Toledo and majoring in nursing. Next, we have Rachel Crombley, Washtenaw Community College, majoring in radiology. Next up is Brianna Dye. She'll be attending Siena Heights and majoring in aesthetic nursing. Thank you so much.
Just needs to come down a lot. There we go. All right, well, this was my first TFT, so this is my first decision day out here with my class, and I just have to say I came with them at the beginning of their sophomore year, and they've just been a phenomenal group. They made me laugh all the time. We had lots of food parties and played a lot of Uno. Card throwing was a big thing in our room, practicing card throwing constantly, kind of scaring me a little bit, but it was really fun. So we'll go ahead and introduce, starting with Lila Grimsley. She is going to Michigan State. And Lila will be majoring in zoology. All right. Next, we have Kylie Gerganis. She's going to be going to Monroe County Community College. Major is undecided right now, but she plans to start there and then transfer to another university. Next, we have Sarah Guzman. Sarah is going to be entering the workforce. All right. Next, we have Olivia Merkel. Olivia is going to be going to Monroe County Community College, and her major is undecided right now. All right, next we have Evan Harbo. He is going to Monroe County Community College. Evan's going to be majoring in computer science. All right, next we have Sam Haynes. Here he comes. Sam is going to Monroe County Community College, and he's going to be majoring in business management and marketing. Next, we have Kale Head. Kale is going to be joining the Michigan Electrical Union, and he is going to become a lineman. Okay, next we have Miles Gunn. Miles is going to be going to Monroe County Community College, and then he's going to be transferring to BGSU to major in graphic design. Okay, next we have Chloe Gunter. She's going to Concordia University to major in physical therapy, and while she's there, she's also going to continue her track and field and cross-country career. And last but not least, we have Giuliano Carpinetta. Giuliano's going to be going to Monroe County Community College to major in business to become an entrepreneur. Awesome. I wish you all the best. You guys have been an amazing TFT.
Thank you.
That's not awkward at all.
No. All right. First off, I'd like to say thank you to the TFTs who allowed this group to join me this year. It was the only way that we were able to run student council, but it was a fun time, and I will say I look forward to meeting with them every week. So thank you to all of the other TFTs who graciously allowed them to join us. Really, what is there to say? It's been a kind of a crazy 4 years. Obviously, the last 15 months has been nothing close to normal. But when we left, we still would meet as a class, and I would say that I really look forward to it. Like, in March, April, May last year, it was something that I really had fun. We met at least once a week where a lot of the other students didn't come, but they still came. We would hang out. We would kind of keep each other sane. So first off, thank you for that, guys. Secondly, I don't want to go any longer than this, so let's go ahead and announce the students. All right, first we have Mallory Everly. Mal plans on attending Grand Valley State University, studying political science and multimedia journalism, eventually working her way over to law school. Next up, Rainey Owens, attending Spring Arbor University, studying early childhood education. Awesome. Next, Mitchell Meyer, the only one that did not write the name on the same side as all the other information. University of Michigan, Ross School of Business, studying business administration. Next, we have Madison Johnson, attending University of Tampa, in the honors program, studying criminal justice. Next up, Tara Kennedy, come on. She's going to study at the John Jay College of Criminal Justice, double majoring in forensic psychology and accounting. She will be playing on the women's soccer team. Congratulations. Next, Charlize Meyerchop, attending Xavier University, double majoring in pre-med and psychology. And last but not least, Jenna Hammond, attending Adrian College, studying fashion merchandising.
Awesome. Hi. Hi, I'm Mrs. Kern. This is my TFT, and I'm so very proud of them. There's not much more to say than that. I'm so happy that they've come today. So first we have Jordan Killingback, who's going to the College of Atlantic in Bar Harbor, Maine. Parker Johnson is going to Western. What are you studying, Parker? Maya Kasperzak, Wayne State University. Owen Johnson, Ferris State, Construction Management. And Logan King, Air Force.
Awesome. Congratulations. Thank you, Ms. Kern.
everyone. We have two teachers here because this TFT has had many teachers throughout their experience. They first started with me as freshmen. I was pregnant then as well, so they got a maternity sub. Then there was Mr. McConaughey and another sub. And I moved out of the classroom, and now they have Ms. Hope. So they are used to changes, and this year has definitely put them through more changes, which I know will provide them success in their future.
So after many TFT teachers, this group finally found their home for their senior year with me, and I'm so very proud of them. Jacob Blosser will be attending University of Michigan to major in electrical engineering. He'll be awesome in that next corporation that he chooses. AJ Billingsley will be attending Olivet College to major in accounting and play football for the Olivet Comets. He'll work in finance. Lucas Beck will be attending Monroe County Community College for business management. He dreams of being a financial planner. Caleb Blackwell is attending Michigan State University. He will study pre-med and decide what medical school will be lucky enough to get him. Avery Knauer will be attending University of Toledo to study nursing. Go Rockets! Katie Branshaw Nash will be attending University of Toledo to major in criminal justice. She dreams of being a defense attorney. Brooke Benitez is attending Monroe County Community College after being awarded the Presidential Scholarship. She will continue in pediatric nursing at Mercy College of Ohio. Tori Bray will be attending Monroe College of Beauty. She'll be opening her own shop shortly in Monroe. Elizabeth Gibson will be attending Madonna University to be a crime lab technician. Chancey Boyce will be attending Adrian College to study law. He plans on going into the specialty of elder care law. With a special shout out to his mom, Mrs. Boyce, watching with her class from Custer Elementary School. And last but not least, Ryan Berry, a retired NASA scientist, is returning to Monroe High School to get his high school diploma at the young age of 17. He will continue his scholarly pursuit at the International Janitorial Cleaning Services Association. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Hello, I have the pleasure of introducing my TFT and also Miss Brown's TFT today. So I've got quite the lineup. We're gonna start with one of my family members, Garrett Lewis. He is going to Manchester University to study software engineering. Kaylee Kohlberg is going to Henry Ford to study surgical and technology. Zach Kohlberg is going into construction trades for electrical. Awesome. Daniel Kasanovich is going into the Navy as a bosun's mate. Matthew Kovakovich is going to Monroe County Community College to study welding. Anderson Knight is going into trade schools. Tyler Lacombe is going to Monroe County Community College and then transferring to EMU to study construction management. Dominic Levick is going to Eastern Michigan University to study pre-med in biology. Sinai Kiles is going to Monroe County Community College and then transferring to UT for clinical psychology. Awesome. Morgan Burkett has her own cheering section and is going to Toledo for speech pathology. Sheridan Casper is going to Toledo University for exercise science. Marina Cerrone is going to Calvin University for pre-med and psychology. Tabitha Burt is going to Siena Heights and then transferring to NMU for early childhood education. And Morgan is going to EMU, and she is going into pre-med.
I'm Mr. McCluskey, and I would like to take a moment just to thank my TFT who is here, and also the folks who are remote that I've enjoyed learning and growing with you these past couple years, so thank you. First off, Noah Finley will be attending Concordia University, majoring in broadcasting. Ben McLeod will be joining the Air Force and studying criminology. Cade McNew, currently at the moment undecided. Layla Standifer, she will be attending Monroe County Community College. Thank you.
What up? I'm Mr. McCullum. This is my TFT. What's left of them? We had, 4 years ago, I think we had like 21, and we're down to under 10 now through some movements and transfers and virtual. So anyways, here's what I got today. First, Zach Miller, he's going to Monroe County Community College to study electrical engineering.
Who's coming up next, Selena?
Next is Selena Milligan. She's going to the University of Toledo, and she's going to be involved in the nursing program. Congratulations. Next is Olivia Moore, who is also attending the University of Toledo, and she will be involved in the business program. Seniors, proud of all of you. Love you. Going to miss you. And just know that we'll always be thinking about you. Have a good day.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Mrs. Poupard, and this is my awesome TFT. We've been together for 4 years now. I am very proud of each and every one of them. We've been through a lot. They stuck by my side. I was out for some personal reasons last year, and I appreciate all of your guys' support. I love you all. Good luck in your next ventures. First, we have Jillian Doderline. She will be attending Grand Valley State University, going into pre-dental. Next, we have Avery Drake. She is going into the U.S. Navy, and she's going to become a hospital corpsman. Next, we have Matthew Duell. He will be attending Michigan State University, going into pre-med. Next is Maddie Dunn. She is going to Henry Ford College, going into small business management. Next, we have Brennan Dykes. He's going to Monroe County Community College and then transferring to Ferris State to study welding. Next is Philip Isaac. He is going to Monroe County Community College to study auto mechanics. And his twin brother, Zach Isaac, is also going to Monroe County Community College to study auto mechanics. And I've adopted Ty Putnam from Miss Fiorito's TFT. Ty is also going to Monroe County Community College, and he's undecided at this time, but good luck to you, Ty. Thank you.
So, my name is Mr. Roush, and thank you. I'm actually pretty good at that. My TFT also shrank as changes happened, but I've got six folks here today, two of which weren't in my TFT last year, and getting to know them, obviously under these conditions was difficult but rewarding. And the other four, I've been telling them that I'm their school dad for 4 years. And if you ask them, that would essentially mean that there's lots of bad jokes and sarcasm. If you ask me, it means I have to tell them to put their phone away every 5 minutes. But I think we can all agree that it means that if they ever need anything, all they have to do is reach out and I'll be there for them. So the six I have with us today, Tobias Needham. Tobias is currently undecided. Hannah Noblett, who's going to Monroe County Community College. Macy Palicki, going to the University of Toledo, pre-dental. Mandy Pekovich, going to Monroe County Community College, and then going to Europe. Antone Petty, going to Monroe County Community College for welding and electrical. And Chloe Webb, going to Stotzenberger College for veterinary technician. Congratulations, seniors.
Okay, I'm Mr. Reed. I adopted this TFT when they were in 10th grade. This was my first year with a TFT as I came from the elementary school. One thing that was really great about it, Dominic, him and I were remembering earlier today that when I first had him in class, I was taller than him, and that's not the case today. But first up, Kai Nipper is going to the University of U of M Dearborn Mechanical Engineering. Congratulations. Dominic Rivard is going into the trades. Ashley Rathbun, Tiffin University, where she'll be studying forensic science and continue playing soccer. O.B. Powell, he will be attending Olivet College as a student athlete and studying criminal justice. Gracie Primo is not here today, but she is undecided. Josh Prophet, he is undecided at the moment. However, he is going to be working, joining the workforce as a paid intern this summer that he just secured. Thank you.
Hi, everybody. I'm Mr. Shade. Inside joke for all the AP language and comp people. I now know what it feels like to be the 17th kid at the end of the Socratic Circle. I told you nobody would laugh, Haley. Anyway, oh, by the way, I agree. Anyway, this is my TFT. We started out with 21 students. These are our survivors, I guess. It seems in some ways like it's been a really long time, but in some ways gone by really, really fast. So here's my TFT. First is Haley Shank. She's gonna go to Heidelberg University. She's gonna focus on early childhood education, and she's playing softball at Heidelberg, so congratulations. Next is Emma Cisney. Emma's going to U of M. She says she's undecided, and let me tell you, when she decides, boy, is whatever she goes into gonna be lucky. She can do it all. Congrats, Emma. Next is Logan Skidmore. Logan is going to Eastern Michigan, and he's going to study nursing. This is Lily Self. She's going to Kent State, and she's going to study sign language. Delaney Setzler is going to Grand Valley State. She's going to study marketing, and I think she has the best sign. I'm biased, but I think she's got it. Last but not least, this is Will Sharp going to Owens for marketing. That's my TFT. Thank you.
Keep this short and sweet. I have two of our three seniors with us today. So I think he's a fan favorite today. Kenny Lipkins will be attending the Transition Center next year. Keep going. And then we have Zoe Hensley, who will also be going to the Transition Center with goals of working for Nickelodeon Studios. I've got the mic. Can you all hear me? Okay. So I am really excited to introduce what's left of my TFT. Actually, this particularly determined group of kids started to write my speech for me 2 years ago. I thought about pulling it out, but so much has changed since then that it didn't really seem to apply. However, they are here, and I am incredibly proud of them. And I know that they're going to do amazing things. So come on up. First up, I have Ella Hoffman. She'll be attending the University of Toledo to study finance. Next up, I have Alex Hernandez Rodriguez. And she'll be attending Michigan State to study law. Owen Hoffner is going to be going to MCCC for his CNC machining degree. I have Caden Heising. Sorry, Caden, am I going too fast? Okay. He'll be attending the University of Toledo with an emphasis on biological sciences and a pre-dental focus. So he's an incredible one to keep an eye on, just like all my kids. Come on up. Are you? Yeah. Sorry. Daphne, masks. All right. Daphne Henderson is going to be attending the Michigan Career and Technical Institute to get her CNA. And I have one more kid who I think they were supposed to put her picture up because she's not here today. Hannah Hedges is going to be going to the University of Toledo to study nursing. Oh, it played before. Thank you so much.
Hey, so 4 years ago, I followed Mr. Roush, who was actually pretty funny that day, and I was very frustrated. I'd much rather follow her for many reasons. Anyway. Let's see, these kids. As others have said, we have decreased in number, but not in quality. They asked me if I was going to say something really sappy. Judge for yourselves. Is it sappy or not, right? But I'm very proud of them. I think the world of them. And I look forward to the awesome things that they're going to do. So first, Ms. Parker Stamper. We'll be attending Brigham Young University in Utah. Mr. Tyler Sparks will be going to the University of Toledo, planning to major in criminal justice, and hopefully eventually enter the U.S. Marshals Service. Miss Sydney Spicer will be attending Monroe County Community College with an intent to end up at some four-year school eventually, which she has not decided on yet. Maria Rosello Gili, our Spanish exchange student, she's actually from the island of Mallorca in the Mediterranean. She will be returning home
and attending Universidad Alfonso Décimo el Sabio in Madrid. Sarah Storti, our Italian foreign exchange student, will be returning to Italy. She has one more year before she ends up in college, but she will be going to Sapienza with the intent of studying Korean and Chinese. And then my poor wounded student, poor Anna Snyder, got injured during a soccer game, but she will be going to Ferris State to pursue welding. And that's my group.
Okay, how we doing, Monroe High School? Hey, yeah, this is my first time doing this, so if I get a little jittery or say a name wrong, just go ahead and, call me out for it. I got it, we got this. So in order to understand the impact that this TFT has had on me, you have to understand that I adopted these wee children when they were so... had the misfortune to be abandoned at the end of their freshman year. But these, what they say when you adopt, like, who saved who? These kids, and there's five of them today. Sheesh. These kids have been at Monroe Public Schools three times as long as I have. I was just a wee lad out of the university myself. And in order to really understand the relationship between us, you have to know that on the first day of school, I had had my planning, okay? Then I taught a class, scared those kids. Great, went great. Next thing, TFT, what's that? Oh, these kids don't play instruments? Okay, cool. So they come in, and then they're like, yeah, so what do you guys do here? Well, we throw gummy bears on the ceiling, and sometimes we throw pencils in the ceiling. Sometimes we throw Subway gift cards in the ceiling. I'm like, okay, sweet. And I was like, so what are we gonna do today? And we went through the TFT lesson, and we had all this time left. So I said, and you guys know where the staff bathrooms are around here? And they took me on a tour of the school. So my first real tour of Monroe High School was from these guys right here, and I'll never forget them. We will always share that memory together. And I know they're gonna go out in the world and do great things. Not all of them are here with us today, but these colleges have never seen anything like these guys. So when these kids come through the university system, you better watch out. So anyway, without further ado, I'd like to announce Mr. Reed Sandifer. Drum roll, please. Reed is going to the University of Northwestern Ohio to study automotive high performance. And next up, Miss Sydney Roberts. Studying accounting, my future financial planner, all of my wealth and riches at the Grand Valley State University. Next up is Shay Roller, going to the University of Toledo to study healthcare business administration. Someday she's gonna save my life. And next up, Justin Rothman at Eastern Michigan University, studying psychology. And last but not least, senior alto saxophone player, Mr. Jordan Sandoval, going to Monroe County Community College to study welding and automotive. Thanks, guys. Thanks, seniors. Have a great one. It's been a blast.
Sorry. I'm so glad they're finally leaving and I can get a better TFT.
I'm just kidding. I like some of them. I liked Wade a lot, but then he went to work and I'm pretty sure he's making more money than I do. So I'm gonna make a speech. Ugh. All right, so we'll just go through them here. First up is Dominic Carmouche, going to Ferris State University to build things and tell others how to build things. Next is Tristan Tolliver. He's going to Monroe County Community College. Congrats, buddy. Next is Cammie Hudkins. She is going to Coastal Carolina to become a real estate mogul. Next up is Jackson Taft. Going to the University of Michigan. All right, Nando Gandara. Going to Western Michigan University to study physical therapy. All right, McKenna Swinky. Going to, okay, I gotta figure, Valparaiso. It's a fake name. I think she made it up. It's not real. Maddie Stone. I like this one. Studying interior design at New York Institute of Art. Taylor Tekeli. Going to the Michigan College of Beauty to study cosmetology. And finally, my number two favorite, Tremise Turnage. Going to Grace Christian University for psychology and marriage and family. Thanks, guys. You're awesome. I'm gonna miss you.
I'm glad he went before me and made me laugh rather than cry right now. Okay, my name is Mrs. Weeks, and it's been a pleasure for me with these students for 4 years. They really are like family. And I want to say that on Fridays, I look forward to be with them every Friday morning in Zoom. And I think we really need a shout out to Chancey Boyce and Samantha Drugel for holding us together on those Friday mornings on Lotus Leaf Live. I can't tell you how much we look forward to it, kept us informed, told us what was going on, and made us still feel like a class of 2021. So thank you. We've had so many changes. I'm retiring, so I'm gonna take a little bit of time. It's my last one. We've had a lot of changes since ninth grade. Do you remember those red cards where you used to fill out how you did that day in my class? I'd say, put a 20, you're all great, just turn it in. I give you 100 today on that red card. We've had a lot of donut parties for all A's. We've shared homecoming, tug of wars. We've done a lot through there. Pancake one the last day when I got sick. Remember, and you guys took over, and my students made it for each other. They made pancakes for each other because I got sick. But I'm very proud of them. And my advice to all of you is that just remember you're in charge of your destiny. So find a career you're passionate about and make a difference in the world. Anything else I can think of to say? You know, you've all proven that you've done it. You have the grit. I asked my student just now how it felt today, and he said, it feels really weird, Mrs. Weeks. I remember when we were in ninth grade, you said you were going to walk out with us, and here we are today getting ready to walk out. So hopefully you enjoy prom Friday night, and it feels better being with your peers more as time goes on. It has been a weird year and a half, but they've had the grit, and I'm going to miss you guys. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. Oh, here I go. I love you, too. All right, first up, and I got to tell you this. When I was sitting in the stands, I got a call from my daughter. She asked me, Mom, I said, Taylor, I'm at the decision day. I can't talk now. She goes, no, I really need to know. How do you discipline two-year-old twins? I said, I can't tell you, but the next two are twins. Maybe they can call her back. First up, Brett Vincent. Brett, I would have been nicer to you had I known you were going to major in criminal justice at Grand Valley State University. And his twin brother, Dylan Vincent. They're always together. They've always been together in my classes and in my TFT. Grand Valley State University, majoring in criminal justice. So remember me when you see me on the streets and you stop me. Remember who I was to you one day. Next up, Lauren Wagner. So proud of Lauren. Lauren took advantage of all our career technical, and you gotta stop for a minute. You gotta stop. Come here and stop. She took a lot of our career and technical education, the technical classes out in F-Wing, and I'm so proud of her. She's putting that to use. Lauren has enlisted in the United States Army National Guard. She'll be leaving July 6th and will be stationed at Fort Jackson in South Carolina. She's going to be working on the Black Hawk helicopters. And Lauren, you make me proud. You make the women proud. Thank you. United States Army National Reserve, and we thank you for your service. Mm-hmm. All right, next up, Kaylin Wallace. Grand Valley State University. She's always talked about this major, so I know she's dedicated to it. She's going to major in natural resource management. Next up, Parker Welch. Parker is going to attend Albion University and get a degree, and he's going to also continue his baseball career, which he truly loves. And last but not least, Jaden White. Jaden will be attending Monroe County Community College, and she's majoring in psychology. And next up, we have last but not least, Miss Windleborn.
Good afternoon. The pressure of being last, I don't know how that happened, just the end of the alphabet. My students all know that I'm very uncomfortable talking in front of people, which I guess is odd for a music teacher who spends their life in front of people, but I am just thrilled to introduce my TFT. I have loved having them in class since they were freshmen. They were very goofy when they were freshmen, and seeing them today, I'm just a little overwhelmed. They're so grown up. The last time I saw them was a year and a half ago, and they still were like little kids. So I'm very proud to introduce today Erica Wood. Erica will be attending the University of Toledo to major in psychology. Next, we have Jamie Young. Jamie will be attending Monroe County Community College, and she is undecided on a major. Next is Dylan Wright. Dylan will be attending Monroe County Community College and then Eastern Michigan University to study computer science and electrical engineering. Okay. Next we have Sean Willis. Sean has enlisted in the Army where he will be a horizontal construction engineer and he leaves soon for basic training. Next we have Bryce Younglove. He is going to Monroe County Community College and then Western Michigan University to major in biomedical science. And finally, John Zarecki. John will be attending Lawrence Tech to major in mechanical engineering. You guys, I'm very proud of you, and I know that you're going to do amazing things. So thank you all so much.
All right. Well, thank you, TFT teachers and our seniors, for your declarations. We are so proud of you. At this time, I'd like to turn over the program to Mrs. Warnke and Mr. Hookrattle to announce our poster contest winners and scholarship awards.
Hey everybody, we appreciate all of you coming out today. It's great to see you in person. First thing we're gonna announce are the five poster winners. So we wanna thank the Monroe Parent Club for sponsoring that. If your name is announced, we'd love you to stand up and hold up your poster for everybody to see. And you can stop at the banner afterwards and we'll give you a $50 Amazon gift card. Announce the winners?
Absolutely. Before I announce the winners, because I know you're excited about that, I do have one request from the senior class. Would you please pass English 12B?
And senior math.
Please. You have till May 28th. Thank you. And now for our first poster winner. Bottom up or doesn't matter? Sarah Reyna. Sarah's way down there. Beautiful, good job. Next, Avery Drake. Where's Avery? There she is, beautiful. Go Navy. Next, Delaney Setzler. Next, Mel Marvilla Campos. Where'd she go? Where's Mel? I know she's here, I saw her. There it is, beautiful, very colorful. Like it. And the last winner, Owen Johnson. Way to go, Owen. Go Bulldogs. That's all I got.
We have scholarships.
Oh, we do? Oh, we're going to draw for some scholarships now. That's cool.
Okay, same thing. $500 scholarship. We'll ask that you come see us at the banner table afterwards. We'll give you a certificate and then tell you some kind of directions for that for payment in August. Okay, it's all you.
Jackson Taft. Brooklyn Figueroa.
One more.
One more?
Yep.
And the third and final, Brianna Dye.
Come see us afterwards. Congratulations.
Thank you, counselors, and congratulations, poster winners and scholarship winners. Thank you all for attending today's celebration. We are so proud of our Monroe Trojans and congratulate them on all their accomplishments. We know they will do great things in the future. Thank you again. Please stay safe, Trojans, and have a wonderful day. We'll see you at prom. Thank you.
Thank you.